This time we are going to talk about how the pagans touched the East and West Banks and influenced present religions and what happened with pagans in early Christian period and during Islamic conquest. The transition between paganism and three major monotheistic religions in the Southern Levant is one of the themes that intrigues the army of different scholars. Pagans were very connected to the cycles of the earth. And like many of ancient people, tried to reckon with nature and understand how and why they exist, and what would be the way to survive in their world. Regarding Jordan, first of all, we have to understand that modern day Jordan didn't exist as a state until 1920s. So the ancient geography has been much different than what we have in modern time. The major focus is the Byzantine and Islamic period, which include research and sites on both the East and the West Bank. The closer look should be taken at the religious affiliation of the population in southern Jordan, namely from Wadi Mujib, which is area near Madaba on the Dead Sea, to Aqaba, or ancient Iwa, during the Byzantine and early Islamic period, after the end of the Nabataean Kingdom, and after the end of the classical Roman age, when pagans switched to Christianity in the 4th century AD. It coincided with the proclamation of the Constantine the Great, who elevated Christianity as a state religion within the Roman Empire. By the mid-5th century AD, the pagan population disappeared, and after the Muslim conquest in the mid-7th century AD, we have a growth of Muslim community and shrinking of the Christian population, which consequently led to 10th century Muslim domination of the Levant. The religious shift took a couple of centuries, and we can attest to this change by studying different sites in Sinai, in the West Bank, in ancient Petra, and in Palestina Tertia, which included all these territories. So, Sinai Peninsula was on the west side, and southern Jordan was the eastern boundary of that territory. The last major pagan temple built by the Roman Empire was located in the city of Rabbah. And it was erected between 284 AD and 305 AD, during the reign of Diocletian and Maximian in the so-called Tetrarchy. So the first mention of the Christian community in southern Jordan is recorded during the final persecution of them between 303 and 311. And many of local Christians were sent by Roman authorities two copper mines in Hainan in southern Jordan, where many of them perished due to very harsh working conditions. However, there are also accounts of Christian persecutions in Petra and ancient Zoara, which is on the southern tip of the Dead Sea, in the site called Ghor Safi in modern times. In the meantime, the first bishop was attested in Iowa, modern-day Aqaba, in 325 AD, which marks the start of the church hierarchy, while some earthquakes and epidemics of plague had been the turning point for many civilizations, including those on the west and east banks. While the same could be said about the catastrophic earthquake of 363 AD that devastated the southern Jordan. During that earthquake, many pagan temples were destroyed and left in the ruinous state until the 6th century AD, when Christians inserted churches into some already destroyed pagan temples. That was the period when paganism started to fade away and Christianity became the major religion. And thus, remaining pagans were persecuted by the empire. For instance, pagans of Petra couldn't rebuild their temples, and after the earthquake, no public manifestations of paganism were recorded in Petra. However, the minority of pagans lived in the area in early 5th century AD when a famous monk, Marsalma, appeared on the horizon. Salma traveled with a band of monks who destroy pagan temples and synagogues of Jews in Jordan and Palestine. So when they arrived to Petra, the population didn't allow them to enter the city in order to avoid the troubles. According to the hagiographic tradition, Salma prayed to God when he and his disciples saw closed doors and gates, and the storm broke out, destroying a part of the city wall. After Petra pagans saw the outcome of his prayers, many of them converted immediately to Christianity, including some of pagan priests. However, these events cannot be proved historically. It cannot be verified that his prayers destroyed the city walls, because to every religious narrative, such events, miraculous events, are used to prove the validity of their belief system. Drawings and inscriptions from Wadi Rum, dating from 4th to 6th centuries AD, have no Christian symbols, except few of them with the cross and Jesus written in his might, which is some kind of a Proto-Arabic from that part of Arabian Peninsula. It seems that nomads from Wadi Rum remained to be pagans. And after the Muslim conquest, the pagan nomads directly converted to Islam. So the shift didn't take the normal turn between paganism, Christianity, and Islam, but they directly converted from Islam, sorry, from paganism to Islam. We're talking about the period between 634 and 636, when Udruk, a small site near Petra, towards the west, and Ayla, that we already mentioned as modern-day Aqaba, were the earliest Muslim settlements in southern Jordan. Humeima, which is located 280 kilometers south of Amman, is an important site because the Abbasid family lived there, and from Humeima, they started the overthrow of Umayyad dynasty, while on the other hand, the site was populated by Nabataeans, and later on, Humeima was a significant Roman garrison between Petra and Wadi Rum. When Abbasid plotted the overthrow of Umayyads, it happened in 749-750 AD. So the first Abbasid house were born there. What is also important about the site of Humeima is that besides mosques, besides the garrison where Roman legionaries lived, there was also a small villa, a small house, where the head of garrison, the commander of the garrison lived. There were a couple of baths and five churches, but they didn't survive as temples. Instead, many of them were turned into houses for servants, which indicated that Christians didn't live in that area anymore. On the other hand, the monastery near Lot's Cave in ancient Zoara, again, modern-day Ghor Safi, functioned until the beginning of the 9th century as a Christian shrine. And then it was abandoned. While the tomb of Aaron is another site in Petra on the hilltop, and this site is a pilgrimage monastery in use until 9th century. The tomb of Aaron, which is actually the shrine for three monotheistic religions, doesn't contain any human remains. The 9th century represents the turning point and the end of Christian thriving in southern Jordan. So when Crusaders came to meet Orthodox Christians in Petra, Karak, and Shobak, they didn't find many of them, particularly not in Petra. While during Mamluk period, which started in 1260, Christian communities in Karak and Shobak still existed. They prospered as merchants, and according to Ottoman census from first decades of the Ottoman rule, which started in 1517, the number of Christian and Muslim households were written down, and in Karak, Christians remained the majority in the early Ottoman period, while in Shobak they already became a minority. In other episodes, we can talk about these topics, the number of Christians in the southern Levant, their conversion to Islam, the number of pagans in southern Levant and their conversion to both Christianity and Islam in some other episode. That will be all for now.